I'm C.J. Peters. I'm a professor in the Department of Pathology and Microbiology and Immunology. I was working at Fort Detrick at the time that Saddam Hussein invaded Kuwait. And like a lot of Americans, I stayed up watching CNN that night in the tanks and so on. And I went in the next morning and I got a call from a guy in headquarters, and he said, "There's something that I've got to tell you, but you're not cleared to know it." And I said, "Oh, what?" So they cleared everyone quickly, and they said, "You know, Saddam Hussein has an active program in developing biological agents, particularly anthrax. And we don't know exactly how far he's gotten, but we have to defend the troops against anthrax." This is the first time that the U.S. military had seriously undertaken to defend U.S. forces overseas against a biological agent. The first time. There was research going on. There was a modicum of understanding of the issues, but there was nothing practical in terms of protecting troops. And suddenly, we had to think about what would we really do? And that was a real wake-up call, as they say. Then, after there was no use of biological weapons in the first Iraq altercation, things kind of slipped down into the background a little bit. And then the attacks in 2001 with anthrax directed against media and politicians, and that put things right back on the radar scope and couldn't be ignored. I think the scariest part of that was the powder that came in the letter to the Hart office building. That was an extremely dangerous powder. If that had been put into the air conditioning system without warning, there would have been dozens, if not hundreds, of casualties, people dead. I think that really said, wake up. We got to do something about this. And that was the real watershed moment.